like the river Jordan, and I will then say to thee that you are my friend. Carry me like you are my brother, love me like a mother. Will you be there? When you find me, and they told me a man should be faithful and walk when not able and fight to the end, but I'm only human.
It all begins with a dream. With courage and time, a dream becomes a reality. Expo 2020 was a dream. The Women's Pavilion was a dream. And today we stand and witness a milestone in history. Looking back, the journey has been wonderful, and we are equally thrilled to look forward. Today, we celebrate the 108th International Women's Day. Today, we celebrate women's achievements, women's rights, and women's advancements. Today, we celebrate every single woman in every single country. Women from the past, the present, and the future. Today, together in Wasl Dome, we celebrate women. But everywhere in the world should be the right place to celebrate women. Tonight, we celebrate women who have broken the glass ceiling, challenged the status quo, and became the role models for the next generation. Tonight, we celebrate 6 months of fostering relationships, engaging with countries, communities, inspiring one another to create a better tomorrow. Expo 2020 will close its doors at the end of the month, only to look ahead to what's to come in Osaka. There is no end, there is only looking forward. Men and women from all generations, from all cultures, from all countries, we all have a role to play. We all can make a difference. And collectively, we can make substantive equality changes so that the next generation will never have to look back. Every dawn is a new beginning.
Your Highnesses, Your Excellencies, and to all our honorable guests. Welcome to the International Women's Day celebration here at Expo 2020 Dubai, in collaboration with Cartier. My name is Liz Bohannon, and as a social entrepreneur who is using business to solve some of the most pressing challenges facing women and girls across the globe, it truly is such an honor to have been on this journey from the beginning to its formal conclusion here tonight, and of course, in the chapters ahead that we will write together. While the Women's Pavilion will close its stunning doors, and the spectacular expo will of course end, the role that women play in this world will continue to take center stage for many generations to come. The stories that we have shared, the accomplishments that we have applauded, and the women that we have celebrated will continue to shine as we build a brighter future together. Not only have we highlighted the success and the ambition and the accomplishments of women, but the Women's Pavilion has played a key role in educating and raising awareness for the very real challenges still facing women and girls across the globe. We are living in the times of already and not yet. Already, so much incredible progress and advancements have been made with and for and alongside and by women and girls globally. And yet, of course, there is still so much work for us to do. So let tonight mark the close of one incredible chapter as we open another chapter and commit to working together to ensure that the role of women, the challenges we face, and the opportunity that we represent will be front and center in our global community.
This year, the UAE celebrates its 50-year Golden Jubilee. 50 years of celebrating powerful women and heroines who have played a fundamental role in the progress of this nation. The UAE has always championed women, putting them at the center and core of the country. These women are the roots of our generation, and their names will forever be engraved in our story. In the words of our founding father, Sheikh Zayed Al-Nahyan himself, "Nothing makes me happier than to see women assume their rightful role in society and fulfill their potential. Nothing should stop the progress of women." From daughters to leaders to the mission to Mars, these women have lit the way metaphorically and literally, reaching the stars. In honor of the mother of the nation, al-Imarat, Her Highness Sheikha Fatma bint Mubarak, we honor every woman in the UAE. We honor every woman in the world.
Pleasure to invite onto stage a remarkable woman who has played a foundational role here at Expo 2020, as well as at the Women's Pavilion. She has breathed life and heart into everything that we have accomplished here together. Tonight, it is an honor that we get to hear from the UAE's Minister of State for International Cooperation and the Director General of Expo 2020, Dubai. Please join me in warmly welcoming Her Excellency Reem Al-Hashimi.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, what a magical evening. After 5 months of sharing stories with one another, I can stand here today proudly and say that when women thrive, humanity thrives. Our story with the Women's Pavilion began 4 years ago when we spoke with Cyril Vigneron and the team at Cartier about the need to tell the stories of women, all women, in a new light with a fresh perspective. We had the opportunity to shine a light on women whose stories had been forgotten or omitted entirely, to speak about women in the Muslim world and the women of Arabia. Women have always been a cornerstone of my society, of my government, of my people here in the United Arab Emirates. And so our natural partnership with Cartier quickly became a friendship. Common vision, common perspectives, and common lives convened a community of people who recognized the need across all our platforms and in all of our ways to continue to encourage, to advocate, and to inspire. In this context, I'm also so pleased to hear that Osaka, the host of the next World Expo in 2025, is considering to host its very own Women's Pavilion, a truly fitting testimony to all of our achievements here in Dubai. As I reflect on all that we have done, and all that you have done, near and far from every corner of this planet, all the voices in chorus and in all languages spoken, the songs sung and the poems penned, I am filled with both awe and inspiration at the compassion, at the creativity, at the spirit and prowess of women and all who champion her cause. Dear Cyril, I am a mother of three boys, and you a father of three daughters. And we've often talked about how we have tried to parent the next generation with our values, the values that you find here on the streets of Expo, values of inclusivity, of meritocracy, of strength in pluralistic voices and appreciation for differences. These characteristics will provide the platform for confidence and conviction to lead a better tomorrow. So, ladies and gentlemen, dear friends, on this very special International Women's Day, here at the heart of Expo 2020 Dubai, I am deeply grateful for what we are celebrating. At this moment, in this place, we pass the baton on to all of you, to all those who came and saw, and who are now empowered to take the necessary decisions required to enshrine true gender equality at the heart of every story. There will be tough choices, and there'll also be easy ones. But all of these choices must contribute to ensuring a future that is balanced, that is purposeful, and that thrives for all of humanity. Thank you all for your time and attention. Have a wonderful evening with us here tonight.
For those inspiring words and for all the work that you have done to bring this event to life. As you heard, the idea for the Women's Pavilion was sparked by this innovative partnership between Expo 2020 Dubai and Cartier. Both entities are deeply committed to imagining the future while also showcasing and honoring our rich heritage. And both believe that genuine advancement comes in the spirit of collaboration. It's my pleasure to now introduce you to a man who genuinely believes in women. He is a champion for inclusion and advocacy. As we like to say, he is a true he for she, someone who has supported the cause of the Women's Pavilion from day one. It's my pleasure to warmly welcome up on stage the president and international CEO of Cartier, Mr. Cyril Vigneron.
Your Royal Highnesses, Your Highnesses, Excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, it's a true honor to be here again in Al Wasl Dome and to celebrate the International Women's Day. First of all, it's my turn to pay tribute to Her Excellency Rima Lashimi. She's a wonderful woman and human being, and she's a real, true change maker. She dares to take risks. She takes to break boundaries and to mix this kind of unusual cooperation, private and public, for common values. So thank you, and now we have to work on the next dream, which will be Osaka 2025. In a few days, this expo will end and probably will reach the more than 20 million visitors. And in the current context, it's remarkable to have brought all the world together. The Women's Pavilion has already reached more than 260,000 visitors, and official delegation from countries, governments, international institutions, families, children, and all of them have been impressed. 80 of the government officials have pledged to contribute personally to women empowerment and generation equality. About 120 conferences have taken place each and every day, always full. But in those conferences, 95% attendance were women. Where were the men? And here, as a man and a he for she, I have to call each and every man for action, because each and every man should feel responsible and accountable for women empowerment, because it will not happen without us. It has to come, and it has to come now. And with the pandemic, the gender gap has reopened. We have lost basically 3 decades in 2 years, so we have to work fast to come to gender equality, and it cannot happen without us. But this will come in 3 points, and the first point comes again to women, to mothers. The gender gap starts at home, so you mothers, stop spoiling your sons. Stop teaching your sons to shine and your daughters to serve. Teach both of them to shine and to serve. And there is one very simple trick, you say no chore, no food. And from 3 years old, you understand that very well. Work on that. The other part is a call to fathers and to leaders and to CEOs, and to say to change the stereotypes that go with that, and also be role models, and to know that also we have to serve and we have to share. My father was a medical doctor. He was a good man, but he was a burden at home. He didn't know to do anything, not even to fry an egg. I didn't want to be like him, and I learned a lot from my mother, but then I learned how to do everything that we should do to be independent, to shop, to cook, to wash your laundry, to iron, to run the vacuum cleaner, to do everything, and I know how to do everything. And there are things I don't really like. I don't like to run the vacuum cleaner, but basically no one likes it, right? So we should not take for granted that there is someone to do, and this someone should be a she. So it's also belong to us to change that and change that attitude to say that for boys, it's fine. We should also stop to tell our boys that it's not fine to cry. Boys can cry. Boys can cry. It's fine. And then the equivalent and the counterpart of the women empowerment is our own liberation from our own stereotype. Because these stereotypes are really bad for the entire world. The professor Yuval Noah Harari has said very rightfully that men are so obsessed to be real men that they make stupid things in that name. There is nothing that real men that only men. There are two kinds of human beings, and some have the biological organ to deliver babies, and this one are called women. And men are just human beings who are not women. So men are only defined by what they cannot do. For the rest, women can do everything we can, and they can deliver babies. And we've had a hard time to accept that simple truth. And because of that, men have imagined so many things that women cannot do, that were just in our mind, but then become part of the laws and have put part of stereotypes and things that have made women's lives so difficult. Because every time women had equal rights, access to education, to financial independence, to actual allocation of resources, they have shown that they can do everything that men thought they could not. So it's high time we stop this. And there are many things we do that say women actually don't do, but they don't do because they are just stupid. So we should just stop doing this. Stop making these kind of unnecessary challenges and races and flex muscles and start conflicts just to try to prove to ourselves we are real men. we just have to become good human beings. There has been this beautiful poem from Rudyard Kipling that he wrote to his son. I hope he could write the same poem to his daughter as well as his son. And at the end, tell both of them, I hope that you will be, my son, my daughter, a good human being. We should stop trying to become real men because we just have to be men. And if we stop putting this pressure on self and stop cutting ourselves from our own emotion and sensitivity, to know it can be really fine to have our frailties, then we can stop and can start asking for help. I've been mentoring young leaders for 25 years of my career, and out of that, about 8 out of 10 were women who are asking for advice. But not because they were not good enough, usually they were the best ones who were asking for it, but because men are told to be perfect and never to be fragile and never to show that a sensitivity can be perceived as a weakness, they don't ask for help. They just try to show up and flex muscle. And it doesn't work. We all have to grow by asking help and advice from someone of trust. Like I do all the time, want to take important decision to share advice with my wife. She has been part of me for all this time. We all have, and we all need to grow to get advice. And if we see that we men have basically run the show for many years and seeing the kind of bad stage it is, it's high time we ask women for help, which high time we give you the right space you need to have on all decision places in government, in boards, and every place we make decisions, because we really need help, and it cannot be worse with what we have done. So it's not the right thing to do, it's a smart thing to do if we want to solve all the issues. So we'll come again, as I said last time, to say to first of all, to all of you, ladies, mothers, sisters, daughters, friends, colleagues, thank you for everything you have done for us without being noticed, without being thanked, without being paid. Sorry for everything that we men have made you endure. And now please come to help to fix the world. Thank you for your attention. And before I leave, I will leave the stage to Sophie Doirot, who will read a beautiful letter that Her Excellency, the President of the European Commission, Mrs. Ursula von der Leyen, has written for us and for all women. Thank you for attention.
Dear children of tomorrow, a few months ago, I experienced one of the greatest joys in my life. I became a grandmother. Since the first time I held my granddaughter into my arms, I have often wondered, what world will she inherit from my generation? Will it be better than the one we inherited from our parents? My parents grew up in a planet devastated by the worst conflict in human history. Their generation worked hard to build a better world. When I became an adult, the world was far from perfect, but humanity was more peaceful, more prosperous, and enjoyed better rights than never before in its history. As I write this letter, another war has just begun in Europe. A war against Ukraine, but also against the very ideas of freedom and democracy. This fills me with sadness. We will do our utmost to restore peace in Europe and to defend each single country's right to decide its own future. I want my generation to leave a better world for you. You deserve nothing less than that. But there is more. We will also keep working to make peace with our planet. The economy we have inherited has severely damaged our environment. We are now changing this by creating a new growth model that preserves our planet for future generations while giving you the prosperity you deserve. I would like you to live in a world where men and women are finally equal. I was lucky enough to be born in a country and in a family that allowed me to follow my dreams. I have become a mother, a doctor, and later the president of the European Commission. Equality is first of all your right. Girls in your generation should have the opportunity to be whatever they want to be in life. But equality is also good for society as a whole. Our societies are stronger when women are involved as equals. Not because women are better, because we are different. Let women fulfill their talents, and men will be better off too. This is my generation mission. I will do my utmost to leave you a better world than the world we inherited. But equality is every generation's responsibility, just like peace, democracy, and our planet's health. It will be up to you to change the world you will live in. And do not let anybody tell you that things can never change. It's your world, your rights, your life, and only you can be the drivers of change.
Cartier has long been known as a responsible corporate global citizen with true roots in empowering women across the globe. The vibrant community created by the Cartier Women's Initiative program shows that we can tackle truly global issues and drive forward change, and that often starts in our own communities. Celebrating its 15th anniversary, the Cartier Women's Initiative has recognized and supported 262 entrepreneurs from across 62 countries across the globe. From innovations in hygiene and sanitation in India, to progressing healthcare technology and software in Ireland and beyond, the Cartier Women's Initiative entrepreneurs are tackling an extraordinary breadth of challenges and opportunities. As a young social entrepreneur, I had the opportunity to participate in this program in the earliest days of starting and launching my own social enterprise, Seiko Designs. We are now a global fashion company, and we have created community and opportunity for tens of thousands of women across the globe. And these are just some of the stories of the incredible entrepreneurs who have had the opportunity to go through this program. Please join me in congratulating the 2022 Cartier Women's Initiative Award winners. We know that these women, please stand up, will go on to make an incredible impact in the world, and it is our honor to see you and to celebrate you this evening. Speaking of extraordinary women, Melanie Laurent is a French actress and film producer. She is extremely engaged in social and environmental issues. In her film, Dunes, which she produced for the Women's Pavilion, she created an immersive and experiential sound bath to celebrate birth and rebirth as part of our shared human experience. Here tonight, we have the honor of showing you just a few minutes from her film. But if you haven't had the chance already to see the film in its entirety, I highly suggest you do so at the Women's Pavilion. our next presenter this evening is, like most women, many things, and she wears many hats. She is a lawyer, an economist, a leader, and a mother. She has served as the managing director of the International Monetary Fund, and she is currently the president of the European Central Bank. I am excited for you to hear a message from President Christine Lagarde.
Your Excellency, dear Cyril, ladies and gentlemen, good evening. The Women's Pavilion is the first standalone expo pavilion dedicated to women in recent history. That is the right step. In a time when we need not only signals, but commitment and actions by leaders, governments, institutions, businesses, civil society, and individuals alike to close the gender inequality gap. Close it. There are three reasons why the time to act is now. First, we have a lot to make up from the pandemic. The pandemic was hard on everyone, but it is no secret that women, as well as young people, as well as poor people, suffered disproportionately. The pandemic exacerbated gender inequalities that already persisted, such as women's greater vulnerability to poverty. Women were at the front lines of fighting the pandemic, often risking their health and their safety. They had to take on more care-related work whilst working from home. And what is most concerning, they suffered an increase of gender-based violence during lockdowns. That was the first reason, pandemic-related. Second, we need all the world's talent to rebuild our economies better. We simply cannot afford to leave talented women behind when we tackle the great challenges that await us, such as climate change, such as inequality. Fresh ideas, innovative solutions, like those showcased in this pavilion, are needed if we want to build a more sustainable and more inclusive economy. Third factor, the cost of not acting is simply too high. If we do not act now, we will face potentially dear social and economic consequences that threaten to undo decades of progress. We already know that gender inequalities in the labor market are a financial burden to society. Estimates suggest that countries face an income loss between 10 and 38% from underused economic potential of women. What's worse, the outlook looks bleak when it comes to women receiving the necessary education to enter the workforce and live healthier and wealthier lives. The Malala Fund estimates that 20 million girls in developing countries may never return to the classroom after the pandemic-related school shutdowns. Without access to education, the gates of opportunity are forever closed. That is why the time to act is now. And we all have our role to play in creating a world that is more tolerant, more equal, and more sustainable. A world where access to opportunity is not a luxury or luck, but is available to all. That will require us to work together, hand in hand, men and women, to inspire and fuel institutional transformation and societal progress. The Women's Pavilion is an excellent and timely reminder and a celebration of all those women, seen and unseen, who have trailblazed societal change. From warriors to scientists, from goddesses to business leaders, from artists to educators. That is just to name a few of the areas that are portrayed in this pavilion. The Women Pavilion showcases the possibilities when public and private sectors collaborate to address societal issues that affect all of us, so that humanity will thrive. I invite you to immerse yourselves in the truly impressive educational experience of the Pavilion. It was Abraham Lincoln who said, "The best way to predict your future is to create it." Let us rise to that challenge together. Enjoy the rest of your evening.
I've heard it said that some people walk through this earth as travelers, only visitors, never belonging, no attachments, no reason to feel disappointed when this world inevitably breaks your heart. That might work for some people, but it does not work for me. Ever since I can remember, my mother taught me to leave a mark, tracing grooves across our walls, teaching me to read in a way that I could never forget. She would say, "Don't be scared. If the chalk breaks, we'll buy more." My mother taught me to be strong, to push back even if it's against her. No one can make a daughter laugh or cry like her matriarchs. My mother taught me to step confidently, to take up space, to never back down. She taught me all of this by accident. You see, at only 5'2", my mom stands tall, but in her youth, she tread lightly. She smiled politely. Not a hair out of place, not a wrinkle in her clothing. She lived with the best of etiquette, head held high. She worked tirelessly to be the woman her family raised her to be, the perfect daughter, the perfect student, the perfect woman. I watched her struggle to live by the rules, only to see the rules then threaten to swallow us. I watched her then push back against every standard, break down every barrier, every expectation, but only for me. This is the paradox of being a woman in this world. You will do everything for future generations, but are taught to accept less if it is only for yourself. She tells me, "I don't want you to live the way that I did." Then she slips and tells me to eat more slowly, to speak more gently, to behave. Her fear manifests as anger, then sorrow, then regrets. I see her struggle to remember herself, only to remember her training instead. As a girl, then a woman, then a person not allowed to burst forth unapologetically in this world. Be free, then you be free. I'm sorry for the mistakes that I made in the past. You let it go, then I will let it go. I'm struggling, I'm drowning, I don't know how to break free. Watch me, watch what I learned from you. She watches me soar, afraid to leave the ground herself. I long to hear her say, "I am free." I long to hear her say that I am free.
I am free.
عندما تتحداك الدنيا
عندما تتحداك الدنيا وتكسر قلبك حتما تفقد الأمل فلست وحدك عندما تكون حر التفكير تعلم أن حريتك تبدأ عند حرية الآخرين فقط بتحرر العقول ترفع النفوس نمشي بقوة وبثقة فيسهل العبور.
I tell her, Mama, you taught me to be hungry, to take everything I can from this world and more, to learn all the flavors, be part and parcel of my generation's mission, to leave this world a bit better than we found it, to create something new. Let my contribution serve as part of the answer, a tincture for the brokenhearted, a beacon for the hopeless, a call to arms for the passionate. I learned how to mother my mother by returning the favor. I tell her, you want rest from this world and it kills me. Who said that freedom can only be had if you are doing it for someone else? Mother, you fight tooth and nail for the rights of others. When people threatened our people, your voice was strong. Your resolve is effortless. I need you to remember your strength. I need you to remember the reckoning that is and was the birth of you. In the worst moments, my siblings and me hear the voice of my mother's ancestors through her. Intergenerational habits are hard to break, but the beauty of children is that we are really good at spotting contradictions. I dive back in and say, but Mom, you don't behave. She says, yes, I do. And I say, no, you don't. You are a hero. You stood up for our people. You faced our soldiers. You taught me when fighting for what's right, never take less, never back down. Fight for women, lift up the people, only because it is the right thing to do. It is the world that we want to create. What they don't tell you about breaking glass ceilings is that the scars never heal completely. Fresh cuts and bruises, new tears on your psyche.
Fighting oppression takes its toll, and you become the thing that you fear the most.
وفي الخوف نهاية الأمل والحرية وفي الخوف البلاء والدنيا
فقط بتحدي الصعاب فقط بتحدي الصعاب نعلو فوق ناطحات السحاب.
The voice in me will never die. Long after I am dust, it will echo in the heart of every generation. Ringing across valleys of stars, the absence of air will not stop me from levitating.
بوعينا الجمعي أجيالنا أقوى بالفكر نعمل وبها
ننهض
ونبتكر بل بالجمال نبقى أمم المحافل فيا جيلا حفت محافله المآسي خذ الحكمة من جيل تعدى المخاطر زمنا تحدده النساء بحثا وابتكارا لا يخاف فيه الأجيال الانهيارا عهد فيه الحرية جسر للمعارف حر التفكير
حر التعبير
حر التعليم جيل من نور تحدى المعابر
جيل من نور تعدى المعابر
جعل العلم لوحته والأدب رونقه هابه الأكابر
Only together can we heal. Only in numbers can we shoulder the burden. Only together we are limitless. Together the fight is painless. I will hold you. You will hold me. Together we triumph. بالأمل نحيا وبالعلم نعلى وبالحرية نبغى ونتكر
إلى عالم قادر مقتدر
One free world led by the power of women
One free world led by the power of women
for a free nation guided by a free generation Together we are better Don't just do it for the future generations. Do it for yourself. Do it for the days you spent living for someone else. Do it for the years you sacrificed to carrying the world on your back. Do it for the dreams you dreamt as a child. Do it for the freedom we've been told is only forbidden fruit. Do it for the girl in you that has longed and waited for you to break free since the moment you were born.
Thank you. David.
Ladies and gentlemen, my mother.
Such an extraordinary experience to be here with all of you celebrating the Women's Initiative and Women's Pavilion. Taken aback being here. Truly. I think we can all agree that there is no shortage of hope and aspiration that women have. The struggle is the denial of equality, opportunity, and dignity that men have put up, obstacles that men have created, and it is on us to tear those obstacles down. I'm Rami Malek, and I'm going to read New Day's lyric by Amanda Gorman. She published it in January of this year, and I chose it because I think it speaks to acknowledging the pain of experience while looking forwards towards the opportunity and possibility that a new day and the future can hold. And I must express what a privilege it is to be here celebrating women, especially on International Women's Day. I know there's no deficit of dreams, inspiration, or aspiration in this room or in your gender. I'm not reading this poem to preach that, well, to preach to you, but rather to acknowledge how my gender has obstructed that. And then I hope that the work that is starting to be done and the work leads us to a much brighter and more equal tomorrow. This is a New Day lyric by Amanda Gorman, and I am honored to share her words with you. May this be the day we come together. Mourning, we come to mend. Withered, we come to weather. Torn, we come to tend. Bettered, we come to better. Tethered by this year of yearning, we are learning that though we weren't ready for this, we have been readied by it. We steadily vow that no matter how we are weighed down, we must always pave a way forward. This hope is our door. Our portal. Even if we never get back to normal, someday we can venture beyond it, to leave the known and take the first steps. So let us not return to what was normal, but reach toward what is next. What was cursed, we will cure. What was plagued, we will prove pure. Where we tend to argue, we will try to agree. Those fortunes we forswore, now the future we foresee. Where we weren't aware, we now awake. Those moments we missed are now these moments we make. The moments we meet, and our hearts, once altogether beaten, now altogether beat. Come, look up with kindness yet, for even solace can be sourced from sorrow. We remember not just for the sake of yesterday, but to take on tomorrow. We heed this old spirit in a new day's lyric. In our hearts we hear it. For old lang syne, my dear, for old lang syne. Be bold, sang time this year. Be bold, sang time. For when you honor yesterday, tomorrow you will find. Know what we've fought need not be forgot nor for naught. Come over, join this day just begun, for wherever we come together, we will forever overcome. Thank you.
put up a fight. They didn't even make a sound. I found a way to let you in, but I never really had a doubt. Standing in the light of your halo, I've got my angel now.
It's like I've been awakened. Every rule I had you breaking. It's the risk that I'm taking. I ain't never gonna shut you up.
Everything I need and more, it's written all over your face.
As we come to the close of this incredible ceremony, we'd like to simply remind you that the journey is only beginning. We hope that tonight's celebration and the Women's Pavilion has inspired you to take the next step in your own life, in your own sphere of influence, to accelerate the path towards true equality. And when we say each of you, each and every one of you, we mean each and every one of you, because as Cyril reminded us, women's issues, they're not issues meant to be thought about and talked about and solved only by women. These are human issues, and we need each and every one of us in our own lives, in the workplace, in our communities, perhaps most importantly, starting at home, to be agents of true change and equality. The good news is that true equality is not zero sum. When we create a world, policies, cultural norms and narratives that benefit women and girls, we will create a world where all humanity thrives, regardless of our gender, of our language, of our culture, or religion. In fact, the shared theme that we have heard tonight of the Women's Pavilion is, when women thrive, humanity thrives. While the Women's Pavilion will come to a close and we will obviously depart from this beautiful space, we hope and encourage you to continue to take action within your own communities. And in this spirit of continuation, we would love to invite each of you to the restaurant Elki Bulan, where we'll continue conversation and connection and planning a pathway towards the future over some delicious cocktails. Thank you so much, and good night.